Hey everyone, it's Steph from Design Spirit Ltd. I hope you guys had really good winter holidays despite of the horrible COVID situation, and that you guys have just good vibes and good energy to kickstart that year 2021. I wanted to share with you some updates that we've made during the holidays on the Design Sprint template. So if you have never heard about it, you can check our website. You just write official remote design sprint template and you're gonna find it on YouTube, and that's the page where you can actually get the templates to run your own design sprint. So it exists on Mural, Miro, and InVision freehand as well. And yeah, we've created that template with the author of the book Sprint, Jake Knapp and John Zeratsky, as well as Jackie Colburn, who is the main contributor of the remote design sprint guide. So probably the best persons on earth to actually work with us on this template. And that template is for free. You can use it for all your design sprints projects, of course. So we've made a few updates and I'm sure you're gonna like them. So to be sure that you are using the last version of the template, just zoom in here and look for version 1.4. This is the last version and that's where the changes have been updated. So the first change, it's something I wanted to do for a long time, actually, but I never had the opportunity to do it because I had to kind of rebuild the template from the ground, was to take advantage of the outlines. So you know that the outlines, you can basically navigate through all the exercise of the template, which is really neat. But there is another feature that's great is here, that little eye. And basically when you click here, you can hide or show the exercise, which is really cool, because what we did when we rebuilt the templates was to, you know, organize the exercises per day, so you can hide the full day 2, for example, or hide day 3. And it's great because when you kickstart the sprint, you know, you can give the board looking way less scary for the team. So you are just kickstarting the workshop and you can focus only on day 1, for example. And you can even go further, because day 1, you can hide, for example, all the exercises. So it's what I'm doing here. I'm hiding the map, ask the experts, sprint questions, and I will keep only the long-term goal. And that's how it looks. So you see there are some exercises that will be really revealed, but you are just starting here. And you focus on the exercise that you want to start with. And then, you know, it helps me to kind of centerize the sprint. I'm like, okay, let's do a long-term goal. And then we move to sprint questions and I can show the exercise and reveal it to the whole team. And then we move forward, which is really cool because it kind of tells a story and it's less, I would say, daunting or scary for the team when they open the template. So that's the first improvement. The second improvement that we've made is about accessibility. We got some feedbacks from people who had a hard time to distinguish the limits of the area. For example, here, you know, it was just a white area on the gray background. So now, you know, I've made some clear borders with a clear zoning, which makes it way easier to use for accessibility. So hopefully it's gonna be easier. Also a few updates about the image weights. Everyone in the world can actually open and load the template very easily, despite sometimes low internet connections. So yeah, that's it for the Mural template, and the Miro version is that one. So also look for the version 1.4 that has been already published on Miro. And so it's a bit different. We wanted to integrate the same system, hide show, but it works with areas, and in Miro, it's kind of a design decision. It's like the areas, there is that kind of weird, I would say, a bit of awkward drop shadow. It takes a lot of visual space. So we decided to have that hide and show only about the days and not each exercise. So to do it, I've added some areas in here, and you can just click, if you are the owner of the board, you click on the title, for example, this side, and you can use the little eye to hide or show the exercise for everyone. So same idea, really cool. Another thing we've done is there were a couple of issues with the locks on Miro. Sometimes things weren't locked properly, and I really took time to to check that everything that should be locked is locked when you use it, so you won't have any accidents anymore with things moving. And the only things that move are actually useful for the workshop. So you can move the stickies, of course, but you won't be able to move anything else that is structural to the template. Of course, if you want to make any change, you can just right click and unlock the specific element here. So you have a double protection, you can unlock in here and then long press, and then you can modify the element. But I wouldn't recommend you, if you are starting with a template, to unlock anything, because with this you really have a good base to run your own design sprints. So I think that's it. If you want to get the templates, you can go on the websites and you look for design sprint templates. You can download and use the versions that you want. And I hope it was useful for you. If you have any feedbacks about our templates, ways to improve it, and please, when I say improve, it's not adding things, it's more removing stuff. If you see that maybe it's something we should simplify, please tell me. Super interesting, and we're gonna update the template in the next month. See you very soon. Cheers, guys, and happy sprinting.